three things we're going to look at. We're going to look at passive solar design for buildings, solar hot water, and solar electric or photovoltaic. Solar energy is something that we've been using for thousands of years. If you go back 2,500 years, the ancient Greeks were building and orientating using principles of passive solar design for their cities. The first commercial patent for domestic solar hot water systems was taken out in 1891 by a guy called Clarence Kemp. Within 10 years, by 1897, a third of the households in Pasadena, in California, were actually using the Climax hot water system on their roofs to heat their water. Solar PV, solar electricity, solar electric panels, photovoltaics, this surely is modern technology. Not at all. Like with the hot water systems, it was in the 1890s that a guy called Charles Fritz actually got electricity coming out of a solar cell. In the 1950s, when Bell Telephone started playing about with two different technologies, and the silicon solar cell was actually devised for the first time. So, how does it work? Well, it's really simple. I mean, we're taking energy from the sun, a free resource. The sun comes up in the east, tracks across, and sinks in the west. So if we face our technology and our buildings south, we're going to get the most energy. When it comes to using solar energy to create hot water, this is the simplest thing we can do. It's really easy. You put a panel or pipes onto the roof of your building. They get hot in the sun. That heat is transferred in the water into a big tank in the building, in your home. The bigger the tank, the better, particularly in our climate where the sun shines and then it doesn't shine for a few days. If you've got a big tank, then you can basically store all the energy when the sun's shining, and it's banked up or stored for when the sun isn't shining. And our hot water needs can be mainly met in summer through using solar hot water panels. And we can also get a really significant boost or a kind of preheat to the power in the winter months. So solar electricity is created using solar PV panels. The way it works with solar electric panels is that, you know, we're putting them on the roof, they're going through the inverter, and then they're just simply connecting into our electric system that's already in the house. If you need to replace your roof anyway, then why not use solar electric tiles, solar PV tiles, that are the roof and create power? And it's really important to remember that we've always got to try, when we're making any investment in solar electricity, to think about trying to meet the technology halfway. So we invest in the technology, but we also look for ways to reduce the amount of energy that we're using so that we can meet the technology halfway and make it more viable. A common myth with solar PV panels and solar electricity is that we don't get enough sun in the UK to make it worthwhile. Well, it's just simply not true. For a start, the solar panels work from light. So even if we don't have an intense sunny day, we're still going to be generating a significant amount of power from our solar panels up on the roof. We've got something called the feed-in tariff. What that means is that your power company is obliged to buy any power that you generate on your roof at a premium price. And with solar hot water, we've now also got this month the renewable heat incentive. So it's another incentive enshrined in law that means that, you know, there is a stronger financial gain for all the energy that you produce from solar hot water. It is absolutely a no-brainer if you can raise that initial capital. It's tax-free, it's index-linked, so inflation isn't really an issue, and it's guaranteed for 25 years.